Greetings, humans. Greetings. Bear here with a mystery review for you. So if you want to see what it is, you better stick around. Oh, wait, what? Hold on. We don't have a title card for this? Ah, man. All right. That's right. And welcome back to YouTube's number one review show, By a Bear. That's right. Yes, indeed. 29-year veteran of the woods. And today we're going to have a mystery review for you. Yes, indeed, a mystery review. But hey, before we get into all that, just a little bit of backstory. If you would just bear with Bear for just one moment, because some of these reviews actually take quite a bit of time, and actually take about a week and a half to kind of go everything. We got to do kind of come up with the concept of everything. So before we had we had the Tug review, so that was kind of a bit more of like a film noir type situation. And the last time, Bear was going to be doing a kind of a zombie review of Billy Tucci's book. That's until we found out that old Billy Tucci was in bed with the globalist, and kind of became kind of a what would you say, kind of an Alex Jones type conspiracy kind of video there. It was fun, kind of interesting, but Bear always tries to come up with something unique and kind of a different theme for everything. So Bear was kind of digging through the crate there, trying to find a good review for you people, and kind of getting down to the bare bones there, and came across something that was kind of interesting. It had to do with a little bit of a space theme there. So with the SpaceX rocket, getting taken off into space there, I thought it might be a good idea to review this book and check it out. But it was pretty bad once Bear actually read it and everything. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Let's go ahead and check out this review and get right on into it. All right. Yes, indeed. Okay, and by the magic of video, poof, there we go. Yes, indeed, we're talking about today. It's Trump Space Force. Yes, indeed, by artist Timothy Lim and writer Chuck Dixon. Yes, indeed. It's kind of one of the very first. This is where Bear gets into a little bit of trouble here, but bear with Bear for just one moment. Kind of one of the very first sort of comics book out, kind of late 2018, I think, maybe early 2019. It was a little bit before Bear got his channel. I got this book in, chasing down the postman. Yes, indeed. I got it from Little Timmy McDimerson, but never really got around to reviewing it. One of the many reasons that Bear didn't review this, kind of right away was, the politics behind it. Bear tries not to do a political channel here or anything like that. Tries to welcome everybody into the to the fun adventures that we have here. So tries not to leave anybody out and everything. So reviewing a book about Trump and everything. And look, let's face it. Let's just go ahead and get right on into it. It's basically a propaganda, basically, more or less. If you really like Trump, you might check it out. And if you're not a big Trump supporter or fan or anything like that, you're probably not going to like it, and especially not going to buy it. That's for sure. So there was a lot of issues with that, and there was plenty of other good books out there that Bear was going to review, and one of the things that Bear wanted to do with the SpaceX thing there was try and incorporate the Trump Space Force thing in there, and at least be able to say, hey, you might not like the artist. We'll get into that in just a second, but you might not like the artist, or you might not like the political theme behind it or anything like that, but it might have been a good book. There's some good things in there, yada 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 yada. So that's kind of where Bear was kind of coming from at the very beginning. And then he actually read the book, and what a mess. There was somebody the other day, I forget who, said, hey, Bear, why do you always give thumbs up in your reviews? You never give any thumbs down for anything. And, one of the things they were talking about was Stealing Solo. The way Bear approached Stealing Solo was it was kind of incomplete. And, you know, instead of ragging on Stealing Solo, he kind of used this as an opportunity to say, hey, this is where this artist and producer kind of went wrong. And if you're doing kind of a book, if you're new to it or anything like that, hey, this is what you want to try to avoid. So kind of use the opportunity, you know, instead of saying something negative about it, try to take that negative and turn it into a positive. Yes, indeed. Oh boy, Trump Space Force, where do we begin with this? Well, hey, let's take a look at the cover here. The cover is actually really good. If the entire book was just nothing but the cover here, it would have been a thumbs up. Well, let's start out with the positives real quick. One of the things that Bear did like about this was the Chuck Nixon story. Did very good with that. You know, basically, it's Trump. He gets into office, and space aliens come down, try to tell him, hey, you know, there's a bunch of space aliens there, different space aliens on Earth that are trying to take it over. So, you know, and of course they all happen to be his political opponents. So, of course. Anyways, they get rid of them and build up the brand new space force to take on the incoming alien invaders. And, you know, Trump decides to go up into space and to lead the charge there and fight the battle against the space aliens. You know, kind of a generic space alien invasion story and everything. But Chuck Nixon did a really good job. One of the things that he did like, actually, was the character of Trump. He was actually pretty funny. Kind of a lovable goofball, I suppose. It was very kind of 1980s sort of slapstick kind of humor to it. You know, so Trump had some good zingers in there and kind of one-liners and, you know, all the Trumpisms, I guess you could say. That actually was very funny. The rest of it was complete garbage. And Bear knows garbage. Oh boy, Bear does know garbage. Let's see, where to begin with this? I forget how much this book actually made. I'll have to leave that in the description as well. But it made quite a bit. It made quite a bit of money, and I'm really surprised. I know Tim Lim is trying to be an artist, and he has a couple books under his belt, but man, oh man, the artwork in here is about as bad as the Stealing Solo. And I'm not sure why. Not sure why he didn't hire. I mean, imagine this as a like a Kyung Lee drawing, maybe, or any one of these great artists out there, you know, like a Matthew Weldon, anything like that. Just hire an artist because you actually have a kind of a somewhat decent story, at least first on. You got this great cover here. Why he didn't hire an artist to do it? It was just that was kind of baffling. So a lot of the artistic choices in here just weren't very good. Couple of things in there where you have, you know, the panels coming together and they're just all mismatched. There was a double page spread in there that just, it just didn't make much sense. Just your sight lines and eye lines and everything were just off. Characters that just suddenly appear, like the the head honcho in all the Space Forces, oh, what's his name? Newt Gingrich. Like, the scientist behind everything, the big brain behind everything is Newt Gingrich for some reason. And then they bring, Scott Adams in, a couple other people. Charles Payne was in there. I guess they had to have a token guy in there somewhere. He just yells out, making money. That's it. You know, it would have been nice to have another line or something like that in there. Seb Gorka's in there. I know a lot of people don't know the names that I'm talking about here, and that's fine because, you know, it's so inside baseball that it just doesn't connect. Even if you liked Trump and wanted to do, I mean, you know, Bear would be in that situation, and it was still just so inside baseball, just so self-referential, what we would like to call kind of conservative ink or con ink, basically just a lot of, well, let's just go right into it. Lots of grifters out there that just kind of claim to be something, but really just in it for the money and everything. So I mean, really, that's kind of where this book kind of came down on Bear was, let's just put in a bunch of references to people. I don't know if they paid to be in the book or if they were just asked to be in the book, but, you know, like Scott Datum shows up for some reason, like a Master Chief or something like that. Like, oh, okay, yeah. I mean, you know, sure, we have all these military people, but screw that. You know, let's get Scott Datums and Newt Gingrich in here. You know, it's just like he said, very inside baseball, combined with a lot of just bad artwork. I would have liked to have seen the actual original story, because it kind of went a different way. There's actually some kind of interesting early Comics Gate Easter eggs, like you had Cecil in there, which was kind of interesting. You know, other stuff like that, it just kind of went way above and beyond the inside baseball type stuff of this, and combined with a lot of just, I don't know. I've got to say, bad artwork. Yeah, it's just bad. There's probably some people out there that think it's pretty good or just average or so. Bear kind of looks at this kind of as the forgive the term, the SJW comic books. You know, the SJWs out there. Oh, let's do something totally different. Well, this is like the mirror image of that. You know, instead of, what's her name? The AOC lady. You know, they had a comic book about her, the Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez or something. I forget her name. Anyways, had a comic book about her. You know, only the people that really like her are going to buy the comic book. And the same thing happens here. So, you know, it's just the total flip opposite of it. It doesn't really bring anything to the table other than this political ideology, which is missing in a lot of comic books, but, you know, look, like Bear said, he would be in the market for this and still doesn't like it. Once again, artwork, Chuck Dixon did a good job with the characters, but just kind of the general story, it was just bland. It's propaganda, right? So you have an incident, at the very end, the aliens are going to come in. There's a wall. Okay, so they're in space, and they're going to defeat the aliens by building a wall. Does that make, like, couldn't you just, like, go over the, it's in space. You can go in, like, any dimension. Like, just go over the wall. The wall isn't going to hold you back. Like, anyways. So there's just a bunch of stuff like that in there that just, it's just silly. It just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. It's just in there just because, look, you know, Trump said something about the wall, so we're going to have a space wall. There's a little bit of, I don't know, they have robots on the moon. It wasn't really explained. There's a whole bunch of things in here, like it connects with different comic books. Like if you haven't read the other Tim Lim comic books, you don't really know what's going on in certain panels. So there's robots on the moon. Like, why not build a moon wall? You know, like, it would be in between, like, the dark side of the moon. You know, we've got to keep out the evil robots on the dark side of the moon, so we built a wall there. That would make sense. You build a wall in space, that's just stupid, man. Come on, man, that's just stupid. So, anyways, stuff like that. So, once again, very long story short, Bear was going to be doing a review on this, kind of having some fun with it, you know, maybe dressing up like a spaceman or something like that, and, hey, having some fun with it, and then, oh boy, Bear actually read it, and, we're not gonna be doing any of that, you know, that's just a week out of Bear's time that, he's just not gonna do, so, probably looking forward, listen, while we do this, down in the description, hey, how about you let Bear know what review you might want to see. We'll see if Bear has it. He's been wanting to do Earthworm Jim for a while. Just can't fit it into a scanner. So I don't know how we're going to do that. Probably Brand will be next. Brand, we just got that in the other day. So might want to check that out. But, you know, once again, Trump Space Force, thumbs down for Bear. Not a thumbs up. No, it's a thumbs down for Bear. Yes, indeed. So don't really give out too many of those. Don't really want... Listen... The whole premise of this is trying to bring people in, and, you know, stuff like this where it's just blatant propaganda, just, And okay, it's propaganda, okay, but don't make it bad propaganda. I mean, anyways. So, thumbs down for Trump Space Force. You know, what can I say? What can I say? Just trying to keep it honest out there for you people. Yes, indeed. All right, well, all this negativity has made Bear a little bit hungry, so he's gonna head back into the woods. Yes, indeed, yes, indeed. Try to find another book to review for you good people. It's probably gonna be Bran, but, hey, leave a comment in the description below. Yes, indeed. All right, well, hey, we gave a thumbs down for this one, but do give Bear a thumbs up if you like this video, and, hey, stay tuned, people. Yes, indeed. All right, well, until next time.
Humans, thank you for watching this video. If you wish to have more, please like and subscribe. And don't forget that bell for notification. It would please Bear very much. You don't want to see Bear bad, do you?